Today, I'm going to go up the hill behind Craig Lodge, where many of us go up sometimes daily, if some of us manage to get up daily, to pray the way of the cross, the stations of the cross, which I believe to be a very, very special prayer. Why? Because we're really reenacting, we're accompanying Jesus in his passion as he went to Calvary. So as we go up the hill, we'll pray a little bit at each station, just reminding ourselves and trying to enter into the scene of when poor Jesus was crucified and take different aspects of it. We welcome anyone who's viewing this video, that they may open their hearts to receive God's blessing on this hill. Many of us going up the hill feel it's a time for blessing, to receive blessings. So we ask you, Lord, all those who are viewing this, that they be also very blessed in accompanying us on this journey.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. The first station, Jesus is condemned to death. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you redeemed the world. Lord, in this station, we just think of the being judged by Pilate, and you accepted that condemnation, that unjust condemnation. And we just thank you, Lord, for your tremendous yes, and allowing yourself to undergo this awful passion, which you did solely for us, just to offer each of us salvation. We just thank you, Lord, for this incredible gesture, which is just love, total love, Lord. Thank you. And help us, Lord, too, that when we too have to make difficult decisions, that we can call on you, that we call on you and ask you to guide us, to help us through those times, and that we make the right decisions, the truthful decisions which you wish us to make. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended thee. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will.
Second station, Jesus takes up his cross. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you redeemed the world. Jesus, when we think of this time when you made that incredible decision, you said yes to the Father's will in accepting the passion and death on the cross. But here, Lord, this is the time when I often think, and we may make some big decision, when he comes putting it into action, it's another thing. And here are you, Lord, actually shouldering that cross, knowing all the pain of what you're going to undergo in the next 20 minutes or so. I just ask you, Lord, at this time to help us when we have to carry, when we carry our crosses. We so often fail, but we ask you, Lord, just to be with us and help us each time. Even when the burden gets heavy. Thank you, Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my own heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Behold, behold, the wood of the cross, on which is hung our salvation.
Third station, Jesus falls for the first time. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you've redeemed the world. Lord, at this station, let us just contemplate that first fall that you had on the way of the cross, the pain, the agony that you underwent. But Lord, you rose up again. And we ask you, Lord, that when we fall, which we do so often, so many times a day, we ask you, Lord, to be with us and help us to regain our feet. We trust in you, Lord. We trust, Lord, that you'll always help us in times of difficulty and if we succumb to temptation of any kind. Thank you, Lord. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Jesus, my love above all things, I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Thank you.
conversation, Simon of Cyrene helps to carry Jesus' cross. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you redeem the world. Lord, in this station, we just envisage the scene where Cyrene was called out to the crowd to help them carry Jesus' cross when he was failing. We know you weren't at all chuffed about this. You came out with great resentment. And yet we hear from one of the mystics that when Cyrene had finished carrying the cross for Jesus for the rest of the way, he had had a total conversion and came to love and know Jesus in a special way. We ask you, Lord, that we too may receive those graces and let us help, especially at this time in this pandemic, to help those around us who are needing a hand one way or another, whether it's a word on the phone, an email, or something else, some other way one can help. And of course, the most important way is through prayer. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Jesus, my love above all things, I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Sixth station, Veronica wept the face of Jesus. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you redeem the world. At this station, I would think of, you may know of the mystic, Catherine Emmerich, who lived in the 18th century, who had wonderful clear visions, especially of the Passion. Mystery of Veronica. She could see Veronica coming through the crowd of soldiers who were around Jesus. And she managed to slip away right through them to get right up to Jesus to give him this water which he was so, so badly needing. And then the awful thing, just as she was giving it up to Jesus' lips, the soldier snatched it away from her and drank it himself. So poor Jesus didn't even get the drink that she was offering him. But he thanked her. He thanked her and imprinted his image on the veil, on her veil. So we thank you, Lord, for that lovely thank you that he gave to her. I'm sure at this time you're giving many thank yous to people around the world who are helping in this pandemic crisis, who have been good to their neighbor, have been good to those who are suffering. Thank you, Lord. This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me. Is home. seventh station, Jesus falls for the second time. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Lord, we just think of the agony you were going through. It's been just so, so terrible. You've come such a distance in unspeakable pain and suffering, losing blood, just been absolutely beaten and scourged and have mocked all the way along. Yet, in spite of that, you managed to rise again. And both power that you had, that determination. Please, Lord, give us that determination and that bold power to keep going when the things are tough. Let us think of all those poor people at the moment, so many of them, who are either suffering the virus or nearing death, or their loved ones watching their loved ones die. We ask you, Lord, just to be with each one of all these people. Just think of the suffering that Jesus underwent. Just ask him, pray to him for his consolation. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death. Amen. Lord, to be with each one of us, to really look into our lives to see why we're not close to you, see if we can make amends. Just help us to draw closer to you, Jesus, at this time. Let us also pray for all our families, all our extended families, all our loved ones, all those who are needing prayer. Station, Jesus falls for the third time. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Oh Jesus, let us just reflect on this third fall. You must have been so weak now, having traveled such a length and yet still some way to go. yet in spite of that, you still managed to get up. You still managed to fulfill what the Father wished you to do. We ask you, Lord, just to be with us when we keep falling again, just to help lift us up and be with us if we do fall. Help us back onto our feet. We just pray for all the people around the world who are suffering so terribly, whether it's starvation or violence. Just be with them all, Lord, and bring us peace. Bring peace to this wonderful world of yours, to this wonderful creation. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, never shall be, world without end. Amen. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Behold, behold, the wound of the cross, on which is hung our salvation. Station. Jesus is stripped of his garments. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you redeem the world. Oh Jesus, this is the most awful scene, when you are stripped totally naked of your garments. The humility, embarrassment, everything else, Lord, the awfulness of it. Let us in this station, Lord, pray that you overcome the scourge of impurity throughout the world in all its various forms. We ask you, Lord, just to do something mega, something really mega to stop this awful problem, to bring this awful thing to a halt, which is so prevalent right around the world. We ask you, Lord, to help everyone who's suffering in any way from impurity. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for what you're doing. We trust in you, Lord. We trust in your love for us, that will bring us all back to good health, normality. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, the hour of our death. Amen. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended thee. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Behold, behold, the wound of the cross, on which is hung our salvation. Oh, come, let us adore. 11th station. Jesus is nailed to the cross. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you've redeemed the world. Oh Jesus, the suffering you underwent must have been something unbelievable. You did it for all and for each one of us. Again, referring to Catherine Emmerich, that mystic, she had this vision of you being nailed to the cross. Pre-made holes to receive your arm, one of your arms when it was stretched out, it was in the wrong place by about an inch or two.
pulled your arm to try and get it across, and in doing so, they dislocated your arm in the process. It was just another tremendous agony you had to undergo. We just thank you, Lord, for what you've done for us, and help us, Lord, to remember to offer up all our own little pains and difficulties to go along with yours, that we may be one with you, Lord, in every way. Be with all those who are suffering. The 12th station, Jesus is crucified on the cross. Lord, we're just still with you in this moment, this awful moment when you were killed by the Romans, by the soldiers. Lord, just we think of what you've done for us. All the pain, all the suffering, everything through you. Lord, to help us to reach salvation, culminating in the passion on the cross. Help us, Lord, to be with you at this time. Think of the awful pain you went through and dying to save us. Help us, Lord, to offer up all our own pains, all our own sufferings, does everything for you, Lord, just to be with you. Thank you, Lord, at this time. Just be with everyone. Be with those who are sick, those who are perhaps dying even today. Come to them, Lord. Let them know your presence in their lives, even at this late hour. Touch their hearts and let them know your love. You did all this in love for us. Thank you, Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Thank you.
13th station, Jesus is taken down from the cross and laid in the arms of his mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Let us think in this station. It's a lovely thought, I think, is to think that Jesus was laid in the arms of his mother, and I'm quite sure this was an example to each and every one of us to come to our Blessed Mother, which he wished us to do. We are his children, she, and she is our mother, as he said from the cross to John. So we wish you at this moment. We thank you, Blessed Mother, for all the wonderful things you did for Jesus, being that special mom to each and every one of us. May we all feel at this time that maternal love that you have. Thank you, Blessed Mother. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, at the hour of our death. Amen. I love you, Jesus, my love above all things. I repent with my whole heart for having offended you. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Behold the wound of the cross, on which is hung our salvation. O come, let us adore. The 14th station. Jesus is laid in the tomb. We adore you, Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world. Jesus, we just do this awful sin. Think of the sadness of your mother, losing her son, losing Jesus, as he was put in the tomb. Blessed Mother, we ask you to be with each of us, and think especially today of all those people who may be burying their loved ones. Jesus, my love above all things, I repent with my whole heart for having offended thee. Never permit me to separate myself from you again. Grant that I may love you always, and then do with me what you will. Lodge, which is roughly 1,000 feet down below us, where the Craig Lodge community lives. And we ask you this time, Lord True, to bless this community, especially at this time. Also, Lord, we ask you to bless our neighbours and to bless everyone in the village. We pray, Lord, that they may come to know you in this time of pandemic. Lord, we ask you also to bless the whole of Scotland, whole of England, Ireland and Wales, bless the whole of the United Kingdom. We ask you also to bless Europe, Asia, Australasia, Africa, the Antarctic, South America and North America. We ask you, Lord, just to bless and protect the whole of your beautiful world, this beautiful earth that you've created. We ask you, Lord, to bless it in a special way. We ask you to bless the whole of your fantastic universe. Keep it safe. Thank you, Lord. And while we're here, I'd like to also thank you, all of you who have been viewing this video or may come to view it, that it is a time of special blessing for each one of you. God, just to bless you all in a special way. And I love you all and I give you all a virtual hug. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.